Number 1. Atlas Unplugged. The latest version of Atlas is slightly taller and heavier than before, standing 1.88 meters high and weighing 156.4 kilograms. The Atlas robot was developed by Google-owned Boston Dynamics with the U.S. Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency for its robotics challenge, designed to negotiate rough, outdoor terrain in a bipedal manner, while being able to climb using hands and feet as a human would. The first version, released in July 2013, required an electrical and control tether to power and operate the robot. The new generation of the robot, dubbed Atlas Unplugged as it can operate on battery power and be controlled wirelessly, has been developed for the DARPA Robotics Challenge Finals, which are set to take place in June. The latest version of Atlas is slightly taller and heavier than before, standing 6 feet 2 in, 1.88 meters, high and weighing 156.4 kilograms, 345 pounds. According to its manufacturer, Google's Boston Dynamics division, 75% of the humanoid machine is new, only its lower legs and feet remain unchanged. Number 2. Asimo and Honda P-Series. Asimo is a great boon to Honda's global branding, and helps the company's appearance of innovation and technology. Asimo is the 11th in a line of walking robots developed by Honda, called the P-Series. Unveiled in 2000, Asimo could walk and run like a human, which was an amazing feat. Asimo had a significant upgrade in 2005, that allowed him to run twice as fast, 6 kilometers per hour or 4.3 miles per hour, interact with humans, and perform basic tasks like holding a platter and serving food. The current Asimo models number about 100 worldwide, stand 1.28 meters tall and weigh about 55 kilograms. Asimo, with his space suit-looking appearance, is cheerful and endearing. He has paved the way for many subsequent walking, human-like robots, but still holds his own as an advanced and powerful robot. Asimo is a great boon to Honda's global branding, and helps the company's appearance of innovation and technology. Asimo has also appeared in commercials for Honda and makes many celebrity appearances. Asimo makes this list because of his winsome appearance, worldwide recognition, and advanced technology. 3. iCub. The motivation behind the strongly humanoid design is the embodied cognition hypothesis. iCub was created by the Robot Cub Consortium of several European universities. The name is a partial acronym, CUB standing for Cognitive Universal Body. The motivation behind the strongly humanoid design is the embodied cognition hypothesis, that human-like manipulation plays a vital role in the development of human cognition. A baby learns many cognitive skills by interacting with its environment and other humans using its limbs and senses, and consequently its internal model of the world is largely determined by the form of the human body. The robot was designed to test this hypothesis by allowing cognitive learning scenarios to be acted out by an accurate reproduction of the perceptual system and articulation of a small child so that it could interact with the world in the same way that such a child does.
It should be involved.
Number 4. Poppy. Poppy's creators have focused on a biologically inspired walking motion that they hope will allow for better human-to-robot interaction. Poppy is the latest humanoid robot and presents the first of its kind. Poppy was created by a 3D printer. A group of French researchers were able to cut costs by a third utilizing the latest 3D tech. Poppy's creators have focused on a biologically inspired walking motion that they hope will allow for better human-to-robot interaction. It has an articulated spine with 5 motors, almost unheard of in robots of this size. The spine not only allows Poppy to move more naturally, but helps to balance the robot by adjusting its posture. The added flexibility also helps when physically interacting with the robot, such as guiding it by its hands, which is currently required to help the robot walk. You can see the incredibly human-like heel-toe motion in the video below. Number 5. Romeo. Romeo has the size of a child of 8 years, 1.40 meters, and weighs a little more, 40 kilos. Romeo seeks to become the leader in the areas of robotic caregiving and personal assistance with the more emotional element. Romeo builds off of a smaller humanoid robot called Neo that generated more than 5,000 sales or rentals worldwide. The robot has the size of a child of 8 years, 1.40 meters, and weighs a little more, 40 kilos. To be as light as possible, its body is made of carbon fiber and rubber, and was designed to avoid the risk of injury to the person that will attend. Today, Romeo can walk, see the three-dimensional environment, hear and speak. The timeline for testing the robot in real-world conditions is projected for 2016, with the final objective of being able to use it in a retirement home in the 2017 or 2019. Funded in part by the French government and the European Commission, the Romeo project budget totals 37 million euros over the period from 2009 to 2016. Number 6. Petman. Petman balances itself and moves freely, walking, bending and doing a variety of suit-stressing calisthenics during exposure to chemical warfare agents. Petman is an anthropomorphic robot designed for testing chemical protection clothing. Natural agile movement is essential for Petman to simulate how a soldier stresses protective clothing under realistic conditions. Unlike previous suit testers that had a limited repertoire of motion and had to be supported mechanically, Petman balances itself and moves freely, walking, bending and doing a variety of suit-stressing calisthenics during exposure to chemical warfare agents. Petman also simulates human physiology within the protective suit by controlling temperature, humidity and sweating, all to provide realistic test conditions. The Petman system was delivered to the user's test facility where it is going through validation experiment. Number 7. Neo. Neo robots have been used for research and education purposes in numerous academic institutions worldwide. Neo is a 58-centimeter tall humanoid robot and was created to be a friendly companion around the house. Several versions of the robot have been released since 2008. The most known Neo is the Academics Edition, which was developed for universities and laboratories for research and education purposes. It was released to institutions in 2008, and was made publicly available by 2011. More recent upgrades to the Neo platform include the 2011 Neo Next Gen and the 2014 Neo Evolution. Neo robots have been used for research and education purposes in numerous academic institutions worldwide. As of 2015, over 5,000 Neo units are in use in 50-plus countries. Number 8. Robothespian. Robothespian is a life-sized humanoid robot designed for human interaction in a public environment. Robothespian is a life-sized humanoid robot designed for human interaction in a public environment. It is fully interactive, multilingual, and user-friendly, making it a perfect device with which to communicate and entertain. Now in its third generation, with more than 6 years of continuous development, Robothespian is a tried and tested platform, trusted by national science centers, visitor attractions, commercial users and academic research institutions around the world. It comes with standard content, like greetings and impressions, to which you can add your own recorded sequences or bespoke content. With a web-based interface, files controlling movement, sound and video can be simply uploaded.
Are you copying me? Let's do it one more time.
Number 9. Actroid Sid. Actroid Sid can function autonomously, talking and gesturing while interacting with people. In fact, researchers have recently demonstrated how improvements to Actroid's behavior can make it look smarter and more expressive than your average android. She knows sign language, such as point or swing, that automatically adapts to the position of the interlocutor.
そうなんです。私は人間そっくりの姿から して自然な仕草をさ。
And last is Sophia. Sophia is a social humanoid robot developed by Hong Kong-based company Hanson Robotics. In October 2017, the robot became a Saudi Arabian citizen, the first robot to receive citizenship of any country. While interviewers around the world have been impressed by the sophistication of many of Sophia's responses to their questions, the bulk of Sophia's meaningful statements are believed by experts to be somewhat scripted. Sophia was activated on April 19, 2015. The robot is modeled after actress Audrey Hepburn, and is known for its human-like appearance and behavior compared to previous robotic variants. According to the manufacturer, David Hanson, Sophia uses artificial intelligence, visual data processing and facial recognition. Sophia also imitates human gestures and facial expressions and is able to answer certain questions and to make simple conversations on predefined topics, for example on the weather. The robot uses voice recognition technology from Alphabet Incorporated, parent company of Google, and is designed to get smarter over time. Sophia's intelligence software is designed by SingularityNet. The AI program analyzes conversations and extracts data that allows it to improve responses in the future. Hanson designed Sophia to be a suitable companion for the elderly at nursing homes, or to help crowds at large events or parks. He hopes that the robot can ultimately interact with other humans sufficiently to gain social skills.